evening, Orchard Park staff, parents, relatives, friends, and the graduating class of 2017. We're both very honored to be standing up here tonight representing our friends as we graduate from elementary school and move forward into high school. It is a great privilege to be chosen by our fellow graduates and our wonderful grade 8 teachers. We thank all of you for this opportunity.
This speech will highlight the marvelous times which have turned into unforgettable memories, and how each and every grade 8 graduate has great potential to do remarkable things. It will also highlight opportunities we were presented with throughout our time at OP. Lastly, we want to recognize all the people who have believed in us and have guided us through this chapter in our life. We truly appreciate it.
On behalf of the graduating class, we'd like to express our thanks to all of you. Every one of you makes an effort to go out of your way to support us. You all inspire us to be the best versions of ourselves and always manage to put a smile on our face, even when there may be a few dark clouds. We would like to begin by thanking our hardworking staff. We are so fortunate to have our Richard Park. Every single staff member over our 10 years has positively contributed to every individual's education. We can't imagine any other group of people supporting us during our elementary school years. We thank you, staff, for always making us smile.
This school couldn't run without a hardworking staff in the office. This is why we are incredibly lucky to have Mrs. Manella keeping track of details for 300 plus students. Mrs. Nunnemaker guides the ship, doing her best all day, making sure we are happy and safe at school. And how we are spending our last of years at OP with the intermediate teachers who have done an amazing job preparing us for high school.
Be somebody you would be proud to know. This quote, among many others, is hung up in Ms. Robinson's classroom. We both agree that Ms. Robinson has done a great job pursuing this goal. Miss R, a pirate's favorite teacher and definitely one of ours. She's enthusiastic, positive, funny. Her friendliness and energy never fails to amaze us.
Finally, who could ever forget about Mr. Odd? His jokes that take us a few minutes to get sometimes, but when we do, we laugh hysterically. He pushes his students to excel in their learning by challenging them at every task.
Every single staff member at OP, we want you to know that your hard work, which goes into making our days at school more exciting, does not go unnoticed. Speaking for the graduating class, we would like to thank you for the difference that you have made in each of us.
Now, we would like to thank some of the most caring and encouraging humans in our lives who we aspire to be. To our moms, dads, who always manage to put our needs before theirs. They always know what's best for us, even when we may not agree. We love you unconditionally. To our grandparents, with their helpful advice and support they provide. To our friends, siblings, and all of our relatives who helped us get to this point, receiving our diplomas. We wish to give one last huge thank you to-
No, wait, Emma. We'd also like to thank Google, Wikipedia, and Copy and Paste for helping us reach this point in our life. Thanks for making our lives much easier.
Over our past 10 years at Orchard Park, there have been many notable times, with Mr. Arsenio's generosity and the work and time he gave up putting together the Sound of Music production, and the spectacular acting and hard work that came from the cast and crew made the performance something we will never forget.
Ms. O'Connor calling us tough cookies in kindergarten, Ms. Wright calling everyone boo in grade 2, and Ms. Pavone running our lovely morning meetings. Both of our intermediate trips to Toronto, then Camp Winona, the campfire songs that we never stopped singing, taking a night trip up to CN Tower, not having EQAO in grade 6, experiencing the olden days at the Pioneer Village, and Ethan Swagger getting his head stuck in a chair. These have all been great times with us, which we will definitely carry with us.
We are also very proud of the sports teams and clubs that were run throughout the years. We thank all the staff members that took the time giving us these wonderful opportunities.
In rugby, making sure we always played with Gilbert, and the massive puddles we slid through during practices, Ms. Robinson and Ms. Priest showing us the importance in giving back to our community, and running so many amazing, successful fundraisers and assemblies throughout our time being in Meet a Week and Student Voice. It is unreal the accomplishments this grade 8 class has made, and it is an honor to have personally got to know all of you.
This is our day, the day we open a new door, exploring new opportunities. As I look into the first few rows in front of me, I see a sea of potential. Potential to follow your dreams, whatever those dreams may be. If you want it badly enough, are passionate enough, and we know you are, you can make those dreams become a reality. I see athletes, artists, comedians, doctors, lawyers, authors, and much more. Like Albert Einstein once said, everybody is a genius, but if you judge a fish by its ability to climb a tree, it will live its whole life believing that it is stupid. Carry this with you as you pave your own paths as individuals with each of your talents. You are all unique. From this point on, we will be heading in different directions, but we will always remember how we started off here and had you as our first friends. You have all made these years something special, and we could never wish for it any other way.
We've decided to finish off with a reading from a book by Dr. Seuss called The Places You'll Go.
Congratulations, today is your day. You're off to great places, you're off and away.
You have brains in your head, you have feet in your shoes. You can steer yourself in any direction you choose.
You're on your own, and you know what you know, and you are the one who will decide where to go.
You'll look up and down streets, look them over with care. About some you'll say, I don't choose to go there.
With your head full of brains and your shoes full of feet, you're too smart to go down any not-so-good street.
And you may not find any you'll want to go down. In that case, of course, you'll head straight out of town.
It's an opener there in the wide open air. Out there, things can happen, and frequently do, to people as brainy and footsie as you.
And when things start to happen, don't worry, don't stew. Just go right along. You'll start happening too.
Oh, the places you'll go.
We wish you all the best of luck.
Thank you.